Titans is heavier,
Yeah.
but it's more streamlined. It's like there's no filler, really. It's
No.
just every episode you're leading on the plot and it makes sense and it's adding on to it. And you need
Exactly.
every episode to understand.
And sometimes, like with Teen Titans, I mean, I guess as a kid too, it's kind of like if you missed the episode last week, oh well.
Yeah, you're fine.
Right? And it's not going to continue on. But like Young Justice, it's the binge, I guess like the binge culture.
You're right.
Right? And well, I mean, now it's on like Canadian Netflix, so you
Hell
could
yeah.
rewatch it over and over and over again.
It is the best. It is so
Exactly.
good.
And then now we had the Young Justice season 3 trailer. What did you think of that?
I like what I saw. I like that they keep introducing new characters. They're for me, because I'm still a comic noob, despite being on this podcast, I'm learning.
We
But
need you though. We need that
I'm the
person
voice
in
of the people.
the
I'm learning new characters too. Like, this is great for me. Like, I love meeting these new characters. Forger, haven't heard him before, haven't seen him before, but
Right.
I'm starting to know more about him now.
Good.
Orion was there. We've got a bunch of characters that I haven't seen before, but I'm still liking it. And the trailer was action-packed. I'm seeing the
Yeah.
new costumes.
Right.
I think the most changed person was Bart. He got rid of his Impulse white costume and just went for like a sleeker Kid
He's a
Flash.
grown up.
Yeah, but
Just
he's.
telling the people he grown up, you
I
know?
like the way he looks. I'm not gonna lie.
Good. Good. And
Core groove being like, hey, we started this. It's like years later. It could match the gap between season two and three, like in real life.
Yeah.
But in show, it might actually be 5 years too. After Wall-E now.
Yeah, it's
It's
BW and AW.
like BW and AW.
The thing about speedsters. I mean, you're my speedster guy,
Oh, yeah.
right? So I'm by that. But I don't think they don't really die. Like they're usually just stuck in the speed. They didn't go to the one 5 kilometers away. They went to the one at like Mars,
Mars, yeah.
you know. So
Corpse wasn't like written in blood or whatever. It's just he just
no.
disappeared.
And usually when speedsters.
And an energy and a field and and clothes because run fast.
Exactly. And then what about with the future of Aqualad and all them? What are your.
Responsible. He's gonna lead more. He's got that in him. He's already acquired that. Okay. You
This
got
is all
this.
you now.
This is all you know. Yeah.
Yeah.
So he's got more of that.
And Justice League with this one, like maybe it's almost like an amalgamation of.
The way they had to show the Young Justice team without saying, well, why isn't Superman and Batman helping out?
Right.
They were completely off world doing some trial, and like, there's no way that Justice League can be on Earth right now.
Right.
In this case, in the trailer, I saw some members of the Justice League here and there, Batman, I believe there was some Flash for a bit, and
Yeah.
Shazam.
Yeah.
So I think they'll be there, but they're not going to be the main.
Right.
Like,
They're just kind of like cameos.
even
Yeah.
probably just to show you how powerful their foes are going to be, just to be
Yeah.
like, hey, they took down members of the Justice League.
Yeah,
You know?
exactly. You know what though? Like I love that they actually kind of more season it with them rather than have too much of them in there.
Yeah.
Because it's like these kids are the ones shining right now, you
Exactly.
know? But I mean, dude, like from season 1 to season 2, I just can't shut up about Young Justice, but the people that they bring in there, I love the Red Tornado storyline
Yeah.
in season 1 and 2. And when Black Canary is like their teacher.
Oh, 100%.
I love those scenes, man.
She's amazing. Her against Superboy, and it's like, yeah, you got super strength, but I got technique and experience.
Exactly.
Like,
Like and then remember like Superboy was like pff, pff, I'm sorry, you're going to train
yeah,
me?
you.
And is on the floor.
And
So
on his back.
exactly. And the at season 3. Years and like all of us. And I remember the to replace Young Justice and I was
Oh
like
my God.
what is going on? Like
Action and action and
yeah.
amazing plot.
Yeah.
Ended on a sour note, which was trend. What's that?
Yeah.
Like.
Like I think like their first issue was something about Cyborg and sandwiches.
That sounds about right.
Yeah,
Yeah. Yeah.
you know, and
It's.
like Robin not being like a good best friend to him
Yeah.
because he didn't buy him a present or something like that.
And they go on with this crazy plot stuff. They had Raven's legs as a plot point.
Right.
Yeah. She took off her robe and she had legs, and I kid you not, the whole episode was about her and her legs.
Just that, you know, and it's one of those shows where, like, okay, you know what? Understood the demographics is definitely for people who are 20 years and over. Uh-huh. You know what, Shane? And hi, Shane. I hope you're having a good soccer game today.
Hey, Shane.
He and I were talking about this one time in the parking lot. Appreciate it for who it's for. Mm. It's kind of like if we went back and started reading all the kiddie comics now. Then yeah. It's kind of like, okay, well, that was 3 minutes of my time, you know, and I guess that was it, you know, and then it doesn't continue on. So, but the thing is that they shouldn't have followed it right after Young Justice on the same time slot.
No.
Right?
It's leaving this weird mix of, is this meant for me? Like,
yeah.
Some of your jokes have like innuendos in them.
Well, I'm not going to stick around for like a whole season two.
For innuendos.
Like, yeah, exactly, you know.
And I'm just like, I can't help but watch because it's like my beloved Teen Titans.
Right.
And I'm waiting for like an action sequence for them all to fight. I swear, one time they had a legitimate reason to show action and fighting, and they didn't show it because they wanted to focus on the other small plot point where it's like...
Yeah. And maybe it's also because like it is...
To see them use their power.
Like, exactly. It's them finding out their, you know... capabilities with Teen Titans Go. Like, I think if they had gone to the route of let's put it in Cartoon Network, you know, but like then it doesn't look like it's replacing Young Justice, right? Mind you, the show after that was really good. Beware the Bat.
Oh, Beware the Bat, yeah.
Yes, that's I 3D, like that one.
It's yeah. kind of like a 3D animated kind of like, yeah.
That's the one. And of course, animated movies. I wanted to ask you what you thought about the Justice League versus Teen Titans one.
It was good. I enjoyed it. It was the introduction to Damian to the Teen Titans because they introduced Damian throughout the movies prior, you know, the son of Batman and who is Damian, et cetera.
Right.
And how is he going to fit into Teen Titans? So they just did it.
Doesn't.
he does not. It was like going to boarding school for him, basically. It was his boarding school.
Yeah. Which is funny because he was like homeschooled all this time and... He's already socially awkward.
He's just not a team player. So it's like, how do they make this kid who's just not a team player play on the team?
and let us know how that happened for him.
So at first he's just like an a-hole to literally everybody.
Mm-hmm.
And Raven the most, because at first he was like, okay, well, you're all dark and gothy. That's great.
Yeah.
But eventually he starts to hang out with them more and more. And he likes who he's seeing. And then he sees Raven. He knows there's more to her.
Right.
He's looking at her and he's like, okay, there's more to you here. Like, what is the deal here? And
but it was, I felt like at first it was more like a distrust, right?
Oh, yeah. He's like, you're hiding something? I don't like you. I don't trust you.
Yeah.
Because, you know, he's a cautionary kid.
Yeah. Well, he is Bruce's kid.
Yeah. And
that the distrust just trickles down on the gene pool.
So true.
And would you think it's like parallel to young Justice's, like, you know.
I totally saw that because in Young Justice, season one, they're all like, hey, we're. A full view, it's like, come on.
Yeah, like, do you think we, like, don't take baths? Like, is that why?
Yeah, like, how could I...
Oh, hold on. Season after, they were in, like, a new place in season two, right?
Yeah, they had a new place, because the Young Justice...
T-Building in Teen Titans, too.
Yeah.
It doesn't seem, like, structurally sound, but I just...
I see that in Justice League versus Teen Titans, I saw it there, too, where the team is just trying to... Wonder Woman made a comment, because Trigon gets released in this movie.
Right.
And they're, like... The main Justice League is fighting Trigon, and they're like doing their best. Like Flash, bless his soul, he ran up Trigon with his infinite mass punch. I think.
Yeah.
Did nothing.
It's like, well, that was awkward.
He's like falls back awkwardly. Yeah. It's just like, oh, okay.
All right. Well, I'm just gonna walk away now.
But then Wonder Woman's like, if we can't defeat this beast, then what hope is there? And it's like,
God, Hera, help us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Then you got the Teen Titans. They're like, yeah, we're equally able to defeat these guys.
Yeah, and I think, like, that calls out to a lot of kids out there, you know, for sure. Because, I mean, to me, you know, wanting to have your dreams happen as a kid, you're kind of like, oh my gosh, I can't do that. You know, your self-esteem is still kind of out of whack.
Oh, for sure.
It's probably still like that until you're, like, in your late 20s. You're still trying to find your footing and stuff.
I feel like your self-esteem is never where it should be. It's either higher than it should be
no.
or lower than it should be.
I love the ones that it should be lower.
Yours should be way lower.
should not aim for that. I like it because like that's like a complete parallel to, you know, what, you know, they're trying to show the kids is that you're equally as capable. You just have to be willing.
Yeah.
right? Like, if you want to consider yourself an adult, don't just be like, treat me like an adult and not do anything about it.
Yeah, or like, respect me in certain ways, but then when it comes to being one of you, it's like, you're not really one of us.
Exactly.
I do like Cyborg's character in the movie Justice League versus Teen Titans. In the Justice League. But then in Teen Titans, they're like, oh, you're older than us. You can hang out with us. We respect you, man.
What does
like,
he fall into, man?
Yeah, he's like, what do I fall into? Mm-hmm. So at the end of the movie, Beast Boy's like, yo, join us. Like, yo, come to this crew. We respect you. You know, we can have fun, whatever.
Yeah.
And Cyborg's like, I appreciate it, man. But when you've played in the majors, you know.
Oh, calm down.
Yeah. That's what he's like.
Have a seat. Have a seat, Victor.
Oh, it's so funny. And then Beast Boy just turns into a donkey.
Yeah, as he does. As he would.
Oh, that's good, though.
What do you prefer, though? Like, adultish Victor? Or, like, I'm just one of the teen guys, Victor?
I grew up with him being in a teenager. Going like, oh, yeah!
Yeah,
and, like, eating pizza. And, oh, him and Beast Boy being best friends is, like, the best thing ever.
Totally.
Yeah. I love that.
That's kind of like you and Lenny.
Yo, which one's Beast Boy?
Yeah. Sorry, yeah,
you're
for sure.
You're the programmer.
Yeah, I get that. There's a movie that just came out like a few days ago.
Teen Titans Go.
Did you see the trailer for it at least? The
Which always goes well with Teen Titans Go. When they make fun of themselves, people are like, yeah, you deserve it.
Like, yeah, that is about you. Yeah, you are emo. Suck.
Which I admit I'm part of. Like, I lap it up so much. I have fun with it. And they clearly have fun with this movie because... Yeah. It's basically about how everyone's getting a movie, and it's very meta. I think that's a good way to describe this movie. It's very meta. It knows to make fun of Teen Titans Go.
Yeah.
It knows about the movies that have made already, like Man of Steel, Green Lantern, the bad one.
Yeah.
And they don't mention it, like, oh, we don't talk about that movie. Yeah, so they are very meta, and it's about how everyone's getting a movie, but the Teen Titans.
Right.
So they're like, let's just make a movie.
Honestly, well-deserving, you know? Like, I mean, I know I harp on Teen Titans Go, but this is kind of their Deadpool roundabout way of doing it, too.
Yeah.
So
it is.
Do your thing. You're good at that. Stick with it. Why not?
It's not bad.
Yeah.
I just feel like if Young Justice wanted a movie, I'd go for that more.
Cause I'm gosh.
That'd be so good.
You've just put that into my head, and now I'm kind of like,
yeah.
Well, you know what? We will also let you guys know when we're going to be able to watch Young Justice 3 in Canada. Because we don't really have an official news for you yet for it.
Not really.
From now. Yeah. So I'm a little worried, but there are ways to watch it, but I really would like. Mm-hmm. And I've always liked DC animated movies.
Oh, I love those. DC animated movie. They've all been spot on.
Yeah, so, and it completely, in TV shows, you know, because I started back from, like, Batman Beyond.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Oh, my God, yes.
Exactly. Like, you know, so that's kind of my straight connections even before I started reading their comics was through the animated series.
Yeah, and they do such a good job with all the characters. They represent them all very well.
That's right. And, you know, there's so much favorite moments in season 1 and 2 of Young Justice. Like, we could go on about it, but did you have any, like, super favorites?
Mine, I hope I'm not too biased, but Bart Allen arriving in the past and everyone freaking the hell out. Like, what is this fast little boy doing here and how'd he get here? And
right.
And him just, like, schooling everybody. Like, Beast Boy is going to a cheetah to chase him. I'm like, ha, that's cute.
Yeah. It's, you know what, and it's one of those things where I know that it happened, like, more than five, same like nostalgicness to it, even though it was only 5 years ago. You're like, oh, that was such a Bart thing to do.
I like the way they do this too. Robin's the one that gets to capture him, the slowest of the team, if you will. No,
the one without superpowers.
but he thought ahead and put marbles on the floor, and
boom,
he's all good. He gives him water, and Bart's drinking it, and he's like, oh, you put a tracker in there, huh? Well, that's such a Dick Grayson thing to do.
But I'm bumped.
But I'm.
I had, like, one of my favorite moments, too, because I really, really love Zatanna. But there was one where it was Zatanna and Artemis, and they go to Manhattan.
Oh, yeah.
And then there's a creepy guy, like, following them. That was one of my faves. Honestly, in any time a JLA member was appearing.
Yeah.
No. And especially if it was Shazam or Red Tornado or Black Canary.
I like Shazam. I remember he's, like, a kid in there.
Right.
Know? Which is a funny concept for the Justice League.
So... I suppose. But what really got me was when I really thought Artemis died.
Oh, yeah. Real betrayal. Like,
yeah. It was like almost like the same kind of feeling as I had when like important people died in Grey's Anatomy, but those are real people, and Artemis is kind of just like an animated person.
She's real.
She's real. She's, yeah, she's real in our world. And when we found out, I remember when we found out like Artemis and Cheshire were like sisters.
And also her father being a sportsmaster and her being ashamed. For sure. Like, there's being embarrassed of your dad and there's being ashamed and, like, yeah. Oh, God,
like,
Dad,
I don't want to associate with him.
Stop like. Dressing up like a sports umpire. And why you? Why is this your shtick? Why are you...
Why you do this, Dad?
Use normal weapons.